Have you ever had a gun held to your head? Right, okay, so move on.
Next to me is a car which has got you under surveillance. I'm here to inform you that in this car next to me is a man who is being paid for by the police, but he works for a private company, Securicar. And he's here sitting in his car, keeping tags on you lot. So really and truly, ladies and gentlemen, it is about time that you dress a little bit more appropriately than being caught on telly. You will be ashamed of yourself, sir, don't find that. Where are all the fat mannequins? Now, if you go inside H&M and you ask them where the fat mannequins are, they'll tell you, oh, we don't know, we just work here. We like our women to be anorexic. So ladies, go to your next short store, buy loads of food, puke it up, and stay really thin, just like the mannequins in H&M.
I think it's all wrong.
You didn't think they give a positive body image to girls?
No, the wrong image.
But isn't it better for the economy if everyone feels really miserable by being a little bit too chubby, and then they go and buy more?
No.
And it'll rescue us from the recession?
No, definitely not.
But don't you think the corporations have a duty to tell young girls how they should look?
I love her.
Aww.
Tell me your message straight up.
Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been asked to tell her my message straight up, which is a very difficult question because I don't even know what my message is. In one sentence, everything is absolutely okay, including you.
What do you think of that?
I don't believe everything's okay, but I believe you have to wake up in the morning and at least smile.
Yeah?
And if you wake up smiling, then everything will be okay.
Did you wake up smiling today?
Yes.
And why are so many...
Life is shit for me at the moment, but I still wake up smiling.
Good on you. Why are so many people scared?
Scared of what?
Scared.
They're scared of dying.
Do you think
because they don't know what's going to come next.
What do you think's going to come next?
Yeah, dead, and there's nothing after. But
really?
Just make the most of what you've got this hour. I don't take every day, I take every hour.
Right. And one of the things we do is part of a civilian hugging team. This is, you know, completely voluntary. And we try and hug as many people as we can.
Hugging is a very important thing. I find it difficult to hug. My baby
hugging. Give me a hug?
I'm not good at hugging.
Okay, so. Can I give you a hug?
Or Charlie?
You both try and give me a hug.
Successful hug.
Okay.
We've got hugs.
Hello.
Hi.
How's it going?
Very funny to meet you.
Are you not going to abuse these tickets?
Ladies and gentlemen, this lovely gentleman here has got a lovely smile, has just claimed that I cannot use a megaphone on the street. The state in which we're in is trying to control you left, right and centre and stop the freedom of speech. This is a very good thing, of course, because it means that the only people that can get into your mind are the corporations.
We're in the public area.
I appreciate being recorded.
I know you may not, but unfortunately you're going to say something that needs to
be said. Drug dealers should move away from the canal. We are watching you.
Excuse me.
You're under CCTV. Stop dealing drugs. Please make your way to Super Drug and buy normal drugs like everyone else. Don't go to the PCSO show with the man in the Hawaiian shirt and the corporate terrorist in the suit.
Hold on. You're not allowed to know.
That is assault.
I'm calm. Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, so you can see me. But hey, I'm not trying to hurt you or anything.
Now, I understand you might be doing it for comedy or whatever. But listen, there's a clear rule. Outside, you're not allowed to use anything.
What is the actual law, please?
I don't know the actual.
You need to know the act.
If
you
otherwise, find out the act.
You need to know it before you enforce it. You need to know the correct act. Is that correct?
Right. Okay. And you've been told how many times nicely.
No, let me finish. We're both on the same side.
You have to keep talking all the time while I'm talking. Right.
While we're talking to you,
I don't want that in my ear. Fair enough?
Okay, but let's talk then. Let's talk.
We are talking. How many times has he warned you that you're not allowed to use it?
The thing is, we are allowed to use it.
Hold on, do not get into an argument. Under what authority are we not allowed to use it? What's the actual law, please? Hold on a minute, please.
You spoke to a sergeant.
What is the actual law?
Okay, I'm telling you.
Yeah, that's fine. That's not a problem.
If you don't mind waiting, a police officer will be here.
Can I ask you, are you entitled to stop us doing something if you don't know the actual law?
If there's a possibility it may cause alarm and distress, yes, we can.
Hold on a second.
Now, I'm asking you kindly to put the megaphone down, because as far as we are aware, until we make confirm that you're allowed,
but the law
please
doesn't work
do not
that way.
Use the megaphone. The
okay, I'm asking you once again a question. I know your community support officers and you...
Section 5 public order, 1986.
Yeah.
If we can see you're likely to cause alarm, harassment, or distress, is in effect,
we can give you a fine. If you're talking opposite your officer...
So that would probably be something that you possibly could be doing.
Possibly.
Okay.
So what you're saying is...
Please have a look on down to you and explain to you further, okay?
Yeah.
Please don't make us slow down until we find out if you're able.
Okay, so you're asking us, you're not ordering us. It's a request. Is it a request or an order?
If you continue...
It's an order not to use
okay.
My ear.
Okay, it's an order.
Yeah, yeah? That is an order.
I didn't put it in
so
your ear.
Okay, so...
And it can get very annoying.
I understand that. I understand. I certainly did. You look very angry.
I am very angry, because you're an idiot.
Okay, so I'm an idiot. Tell me, is it within your authority to call me an idiot? Are you allowed to do that?
I don't really care.
You don't care? You see, this is all about language. It's all about words, right? And your job and my job is all about understanding words.
We live in a free country and we have freedom of speech and we respect everybody's right to freedom of speech. Everyone is entitled to their opinion as well. We don't always agree with everybody else's opinion.
I agree with that.
This is where we get that conflict. That's unfortunate.
I understand that.
And the police service come in. So we try to avoid that conflict.
And it's my understanding, doing a lot of research, that is absolutely within the law in a public place to use the megaphone. So under what authority are you telling us we can't do it?
I'll go and find out, because it's right fun. I don't know.
Cheering the hug.
Come on.
God, a hug, a hug.
Thank you, my love.
Boots have a wonderful slogan which says, trust Boots. So you can trust Boots because they will supply you with lots and lots of drugs. But any other drugs, they're completely fine. So please feel free. Sorry? I'm speaking with a megaphone on the street.
Okay.
Sorry, under what authority?
Do you own the light that shines off that sign and goes onto the camera? The photons. He owns the photons.
Can we call our store? So if you want to phone our head office, you can do that.
That's how we like you.
People don't appreciate being insulted, something
that is movable. So the lady here from Boots has said people don't appreciate being insulted. I'd like to ask the crowd who are gathered here, so if you are enjoying this presentation, say yeah!
Yeah! Hey!
Thank you, I think you're outnumbered, madam. Do you feel insulted? Do you see the irony of it all?
No.
Yes.
Hello, darling. How are you? You are gorgeous.
You've got amazing eyes.
Amazing eyes. What she doesn't know is that she's come across someone who actually does know the law, and according to the law, I can use it. And here we are outside game here on Camden Town. It's very important for children to be trained in ripping people's bodies to shreds. Please, it's very healthy and it's very good for your soul. So come and buy some games with lots of killing and destruction and war. And now you can be involved yourself and kill thousands of people in the most brutal way. So bring your young people into game. Let's make people's minds work overtime at killing and maiming. Come and buy Kill Babies 4, the new way you can kill children without getting prosecuted.
No fancy burger. We work for McDonald's. We're trying to encourage people to buy some burgers and chips. some McNuggets, a Happy Meal.
You don't think it's good, right? But did he nag you to go in?
Please bring your children into Burger King.
What do you think about Burger King, sir?
I think it's all right.
What do you think about the new...
It's quite sporty and healthy, and obviously...
Yeah, but I don't eat every day.
What do you think about the nutrition in Burger King? Do you think that they put anything in their products that might get you addicted to what they have?
I hope not, but...
Do you trust them?
Work on me,
Do you trust Burger King?
I try to trust most companies.
You trust most companies, yeah?
I try to. So, you are for Burger King, right?
Yeah, we're for Burger King. So we're just doing a kind of, like, counter-ironic semi-protest to actually encourage people to go in. Because we're trying to try a new advertising campaign now, which... goes against people's intuitions.
Excuse me, madam, I noticed you've been into McDonald's. What do you think about McDonald's food? Do you think it's good for the children and it makes them happy? Because I noticed you've got a McHappy meal. Yeah? So you've got a Happy Meal. So do you think that the meals... Tell me, sir, do the meals at McDonald's make you feel happy? Young man? So you can ask your mummy if you can tell me. Do they make your children feel happy? Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah? What do you think about the nutritious content?
It's bad.
Yeah?
Yeah, definitely bad. But I don't eat there, but... Sometimes, just for a treat.
You
to make them happy, I'll get them some fish fingers.
How long does the happiness last for, usually? Police hugging department. It's one thing that I do, right?
You're hugging me.
Oh, come on. You've been so nice up until now.
A hug. Yeah! Woo!
Come on.
Yeah! Woo! Woo!